Working with images and videos in Angular can be challenging. Handling media optimization, responsive design, and performance often requires complex setups and third-party tools. You can simplify it all by using Cloudinary, which makes it easy to manage, optimize, and deliver your media seamlessly within your Angular projects. Cloudinary offers a rich set of features to make working with images and videos a breeze, whether it's delivering optimized media, dynamically transforming images and videos, or managing uploads efficiently. Cloudinary has you covered. For example, you can serve responsive images tailored to your users' devices or add seamless video streaming to your app, all with just a few lines of code. In this video, you'll learn how to get started with Cloudinary in an Angular app. Let's start off in an existing Angular app. First, install the Cloudinary Angular SDK. You need two packages, Cloudinary URL Gen and Cloudinary NG. Once installed, you'll see them added to your package.json. Now, in your app component, import Cloudinary module from Cloudinary NG and add it to the imports array of your root component. This makes Cloudinary functionality available in your components template. Next, you need to import Cloudinary and Cloudinary image from Cloudinary URL Gen so that you can configure the SDK to reference your Cloudinary product environment and deliver images and videos from it. Inside the app component, declare a property called image, which is of type Cloudinary image. We'll assign a value to image later, even though it's initially undefined. This will be used to store an instance of a Cloudinary image, allowing us to transform and display it within the template later on. Now, set up a new Cloudinary instance by specifying the cloud name for your Cloudinary product environment. You can find your cloud name in your Cloudinary console on the dashboard. Mine's called Demo. The image we're going to display is one that comes with every new account. It has a public ID of CLD sample. You can find it in the root of your media library. Or you can upload and use your own image. Use the image method of your Cloudinary instance to create your Cloudinary image instance and specify the public ID. Now in your template, use the Advanced Image component to display your image. And that's it. If we run the app, we can see the image displayed at its full size. But most of the time, you'll want to resize your images and maybe crop parts of it to fit a certain design. With Cloudinary, you can do that on the fly, delivering an image that's transformed on the server side, but keeps the original image intact. Let's add that resize now. Import fill from Cloudinary URL Gen Actions Resize. This type of crop tries to keep as much of the image as possible within the dimensions that you specify. It scales down or up to at least fill both of the specified dimensions. Let's apply this to the image. We'll set the width and height at 250 pixels, so the sides of the image will be cropped, as this is a different aspect ratio to the original image. And without any other changes, we can see that the image is resized in an instant. Next up, see how you can use AI to ensure you keep the most important parts of your images when cropping them.